This is another example that you can use to test your understanding of pass-by value. So the idea is that we have these in the command line. So by the command line, what I mean is like here. So like here you would type a equals 3, and b equals 5, and t equals 2. That's not 2, that's w. T equals 2, and then so you can see them in your workspace, and then you'd actually type in rs is equal to smelly function of a, s or t or whatever it is it's going to be. So you don't actually see smelly function because maybe you wrote it, but maybe you didn't. It's somebody else's function. That's why they needed a stupid name. But anyway, you type in smelly function. So before you actually type it in and try it out, what you should do is see if you can anticipate what it's going to do. So ideally, you should pause the video and be like, I'm going to try to learn stuff all on my own. Or you could not. So let's pretend that you paused the video and gave it a shot. So hopefully the first thing you did is you wrote, okay, a equals 3. So that means that a is 3. Alright, then clearly b is also 5, because it says b is 5 and t is 2. Now, there's going to be two different outputs to this smelly function, but it's going to take the value that is stored in t and send it over to the smelly function. T is actually 2, so it's really a smelly function of 2. And remember, there's like this magic pirate wall, and it's got like skull and crossbones. So I'm going to take this little 2. Notice I'm not saying I'm taking the T, I'm taking the 2. And I'm going to send this 2 over the wall. And it's going to go over here to this function. So whenever this function runs, the first thing it does, it goes smelly function is A. Well, A is 2 because, well, it is because A is 2, because that's what it's supposed to be, because I sent over a 2, and the only thing I had to put it into is an A, so that means A is 2. Alright, then the next line says that A is actually equal to A plus 1, so A gets overwritten to 3. Alright, then it says that X is equal to A plus 2, so 5. Then B is 12, and then T is X plus A plus B, which is 5 plus 3 plus 12, which is something like a 20. So T is equal to 20, and then Y is equal to t minus 3, so y is equal to 17. Now, the outputs for this function are x and y. So whenever the function's all done, whatever the value for x is, it's going to send back as the first output, and whatever the value for y is, it's going to send back as the second output. So first of all, it's going to say, okay, so my two outputs are going to be 5 and 17, because those are x and y. Again, I didn't say my outputs are x and y, I said my outputs are 5 and 17. So they need wings so they can fly, 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 and then they go I remember this magic thing happens when they hop over the pirate wall. Once they hop over the pirate wall, then everything over here is gone forever. Totally gone, 100% gone, like it never even happened. Those were variables that were just local to the function itself, and once you leave the function closes, and all the values go away. So we go flippity, flip, 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 and they go right here. So R and S become 5 and 17. So if you wanted to write them off to the side, R is equal to 5 and S is equal to 17. So someone was going to ask you, well, what's the value of X? You'd be like, I don't know, there's no X here. X does not have a value, no value. If I said, what is Y? You'd be like, I don't know, Y has no value. It's very, very sad. No, this was supposed to be a no. You can't really see that. But y has no value and x has no value. But you're like, well, there was an x and a y over here. But look, they're gone. But they got erased because they no longer exist. This is just a giant vortex of lack of variables. But essentially, you've got r is 5 and s is 17. We're going to see if this actually works. So here's my smelly function, 5 and 17. And if you look off to the left here in your workspace, you have 3, 5, 5, 17, and 2, which is exactly the same values that we have over on the other side.